गुड मॉर्निंग ग्रेड थ्री. ओके चिल्ड्रन, टुडे इन आवर जूम क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डू फ्रैक्शंस, राइट? नाउ चिल्ड्रन, आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन टू यू समथिंग वेरी बेसिक सो दैट ड्यूरिंग द जूम क्लास यू कैन डू दिस, राइट? नाउ चिल्ड्रन, सी हियर, द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू नो परसेंटेज फॉर अ फ्रैक्शन. नाउ हियर द फ्रैक्शन इज 1/2. चिल्ड्रन, वी नो दैट 1 इज अ numerator and 2 is the denominator. So now how do we write the fraction in word? That is 1/2. Now children, half means the percentage is 50. Look here children, they have even shown us here, right? You can see this here, this is whole and this is half. If you look here children, this is 1/4. 1/4 means 1/4's children, how much is this? 1/4, 1/4. So that is 25%. 3/4 is 75%. Now children, look here. If you see here, shade the given percent on the grid, 50%. So now children, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? So 50% means how much will it be? These are 10 over here. You can count children, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So totally that means there are 100. Okay, so now they have told us to shade 50%. So what do you do children? This will be this one grid, this one grid, this one grid, this one grid, and this one grid, right? So right from here till here, you will color this, you will color this, you will color this, you will shade this with your pencil. So you get here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So that will be 50%. Got it? Now similarly children, I think you can do 80%. We will do it during the class. Now children, if you look here, convert the given fraction into percentage. As we said children, fraction with denominator 100 is percentage. We know that it is on 100, right? So that means here your percent will be 17, because see here, the denominator says it is 100, right? It explains children over here, one whole means 100%. So similarly here, 39/100. So what will be the percentage? 39. Okay. Now children, this identify the percentage shade in the grid. Now you tell me children, as I told you, this is 100, okay, total 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So like this you have 10, okay, columns. So now what would be the percentage over here? You can get an idea from here, as I have explained. We are going to do this in the Zoom children, so you need to think over it. Okay, children, this we have already done. Now children, move here to this page. Okay, this also we will do it during the Zoom. This is children, to recognize equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction to 1/2, 1/2. When the fractions are reduced and produce the same fraction, then they are called equivalent fraction. They are reduced and then they are produced the same fraction, like 1/2 and 2/4. Why they are equivalent children? See here. Okay, just pay attention here. Now children, here the learning objective is to recognize the equivalent fraction to 1/2. So children, look here in exercise 31. Okay, if you read this children, you could read this before the class, and now you have to fill in the missing boxes. Now children, if you look at this, this is 6 parts, 6 equal parts, right? Now here it is 1/2 is equal to -/6, right? Or you could say ( 6). Similarly over here we have 1/2 is equal to -/8. So what we need to do children is, now how did you get 6 over here? If you multiply by 3, if you say your 3 times table, 2 times table, 2 into 3, that will give you 6. Now children, if you are multiplying this by 3, you have to multiply even the numerator by 3. 1 into 3 will give you 3. So that will be 3 upon 6. Got it? Similarly here children, this will be 2 into 4. So that will be 8. 2 fours is 8. So if you are multiplying this, you will also do that the same for the denominator. This will be 1 into 4. Right? So 1 into 4 will be 4. Let's just do it here children. I'll just show it to you so that you get an idea. What was the first one children? It was 1 by 2. What did I say? You multiply this by 3. 2 into 3 is 6. You'll do the same thing here children. Because you're the denominator you're multiplying, same thing you will do it for the numerator. So 1 into 3 will be 3. Now children, you want to check your answer whether you're getting half. You may check it. What you do is, in the working column, you can write this. And then, which is the common table which goes in both, that is 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So you're getting half. Half is equal to half. Okay, what was the second one children? Second one was 1 upon 2 is equal to 8. Right? We want to say that this is half and this is also is equal to half. That's why the sign over here is equal to. How will I get 8 over here children? That was when you multiply it by 4. 2 into 4 is 8. Similarly, I need to multiply this. 1 into 4. So that will be 4 upon 8. You want to check? Yes, check now. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So you are getting children, half is equal to half. Okay, so this children in the Zoom class, we will do this. Even the down examples if you see. Now here you have to write the missing numerator or the denominator. Now children, you have be careful, they have asked us numerator or the denominator. Now here children, see here, they have given us the number. 1 into 7 is 7. So just you add your 7. Here also 1 into 2 is 2. So you get 2 upon 10. You could check your answer children in the rough. Now here you will get 1 into 2, you will get here 2 upon 10. Right? So check 2 upon 10, which will be the common table 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10. So 1 upon 5, if you see this, 1 upon 5 is equal to 1 upon 5. Right? Okay. Now let's move to children something very interesting. Look here. This is on page 46. Okay? To position simple fractions on a number line. Now children, pay attention here. Okay? The fraction number line to 1. So you begin with 0 and at the right side, you have 1. Why 1 children? Because it is one whole. You remember? Okay, we are talking of one whole. So, now children, it is half. So, you know this is direct. Half of this place will be here. Okay, two equal parts. If you see this 2 children, okay, this is 2 equal parts. Now, move to the next one. You start with 0 and at the right side you have 1, okay, because it is one whole. Now children, look here, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 equal parts. Okay, so this is 1 upon 3. How do you start your number line? 0, 1, 2. Okay, so this is 0, so this will be 1 upon 3. Why 3? Because 3 equal parts. Okay, so this is 1 upon 3, this is 2 upon 3, and this over here children, this is your 3 upon 3. You see this common table. 3, you divide by 3, you will get 1. Did you understand children? Okay. Now similarly, look at this children. Okay, how many parts? Now you tell me. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal parts. Okay, so that's your denominator. Can you see? This is your denominator. This children, it will be, I'll tell you later. Let's start this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 1 upon 4, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 4. And this over here will be what? 4 upon 4. You cancel this, you get here 1. Clear? Okay. Now children, for this you tell me how many equal parts? 5. Right? Okay. So, you will be prepared during Zoom with this. Now children, to draw on a number line, let's see how we can draw this on a number line. So children, now we are going to see how do we represent this fraction on a number line. Let's see fraction 4 upon 7. Now children, now you tell me, come on. 4 upon 7. So which is your numerator? We are going to represent 4 upon 7 on the number line. Your numerator is 4 and denominator is 7. So children, we need to focus on this denominator, okay? Yes, so how many equal parts children? 7 equal parts, right? So we need to make 7 equal parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Children, always check. Okay. So, what you can do, children, you can just number it inside so that you are not confused. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Got it? Okay. Now, 4 upon 7. They are asking us to plot 4 upon 7. So, let's start from here, children. So, this will be what, children? Come on, tell me. Yes. Start from 1. Okay. Because this is 0. Sorry, I forgot to. The starting point is 0. And here it is 1. Right? Let me use another pen. I think this will be clear. Yes, 0 and 1. Okay. So now 1. This will be 1 upon. Because equal parts are 7. This is 2 upon 7. This is 3 upon 7. This is 4 upon 7. This is 5 upon 7. 6 upon 7. And the last one is what, children? 7 upon 7. Check. You're getting 1. Okay? Because 1 divided by 7. Sorry. 7 divided by 7 will give you 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now they want us to plot, children, which number? 4 upon 7. This is your number. 4 upon 7 which you need to plot. So this is the number. Simple. Okay. Let's take another one. An even one we'll take, children. 3 upon 4. Come on. Yes, we are going to plot 3 upon 4. Starting 0 to the right hand is 4. Because, sorry, 1. Because 4. Why, children? Because 1 is whole. Okay. We are talking. Now we have to focus on the denominator. Focus here on 4. Now children, this is an even number. So you can easily get over here. You can easily get 4 parts here. So you take this as like a midpoint over here. Okay. So that will be 2. Okay. Now 4 equal parts. So here. What I told you, children, you could write this inside so that you are not confused. 1, 2, 3, 4. Or children, you can make number line. 1, 2, you know these rings, what you all make it on the number line. You have done it in the lower classes. You could do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, now children, this will be what? 1 upon 4, because 4 equal parts. This will be 2 upon 4 equal part. This will be 3 upon 4, 4 equal part. And the last one is 4 upon 4. Right? And then you get this 1. So that's why on your right side, children, you have 1. That's your whole. Okay? So, what are we plotting? 3 upon 4. So, where is 3 upon 4? Here. Got it? So, children, all this we are going to do during Zoom. This is just to brief you that I have given you this. Okay? Now, Well, now children, look here to compare the fractions. Now they have given an explanation here, which I have put it in very simple terms. You could read this also, children, before the class, so that you are prepared. Comparing like fractions with equal denominators. Of the two fractions with the same denominator, the fraction with the greater numerator is the greater fraction. Simply, children, look at this example. 2 upon 9 and 5 upon 9. Now, which is a greater numerator over here? 5. So, 5 is greater than 2, correct? So, that means 5 upon 9 is greater than 2 upon 9. Now, look at this, comparing fractions with equal numerators. If the numerator of two fractions are equal, then the fraction with the smaller denominator is greater than the other fraction. Now, look at these two fractions, children. The smaller denominator is 2. 2 is less than 5. So, we can say 9 upon 2 is greater than 9 upon 5. So, children, please read this before the class so that you are well prepared for the exercise. So, that's all, children. Remember, children, we are not doing this before the class. This is only for your understanding. All these pages, we will do it during the Zoom. Thank you, children, and see you.